Hello students, looking at current affairs for 18th April, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these 8. We'll look at them in detail. The first one, post-lockdown, India's infection growth rate has slowed down. So Union Health Ministry has said that the doubling rate of positive COVID-19 cases is now down to 6.2 days compared to 3 days before the nationwide lockdown that began on 25th March 2020. So this is doubling rate. Doubling rate means the number of days required for COVID-19 cases to double. Like if we have 50 COVID-19 cases, they'll double to 100 in 3 days. That was the rate at which it was doubling before March 25. But now the doubling rate is 6.2 days. Means after 6 days, the rate number of COVID-19 cases are doubling. So the graph has also been shown here comparing India's rate with other countries. You can see US is in this orange line. Orange line is cases doubling every 4 days. India lies here, you can see. This is cases doubling every 6 days. Then this is here, you can see cases doubling every 8 days where Pakistan lies. And this is the rate of increase, the confirmed cases, number of confirmed cases are highest. You can see in USA, then Spain, Italy, China, then India comes down here. So that's what the Union Health Ministry has announced presently. Also, the recovery rate means number of people who have recovered is 13%, and ratio between recovered positive cases and fatalities is said to be 80:20. So number of deaths are 20%. Then indigenous manufacture of RT-PCR, that is reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction. These are the testing kits for COVID-19. So indigenous manufacturing has started. Even rapid antibody detection kits manufacture has been initiated in the country. It is said cumulatively 1,919 dedicated COVID-19 hospitals have been identified at both central and state level. So these were the announcements made by the Union Health Ministry. The next is give rupees 35,000 crore to PM CARES for bail. So this is Jharkhand High Court which has granted bail to former MP and 5 others on condition. Bail condition is that they should contribute 35,000 rupees each to PM CARES Fund and download the Arogya Setu mobile application. So these are the conditions for bail. This former MP and others have been convicted in a case of involvement in rail roko agitation in 2012 in Jharkhand. So one of them, the MP, is a former BJP MP actually, and this is the bail condition being given. PM CARES is already controversial because of it being set up as a separate trust and funding coming in to it from even Russian defense company, Russian government defense company, Rosoboron Export. Then next is Wuhan admits to errors, hikes toll by 50%. So Wuhan in China, the ground zero city where the coronavirus infection began, China has admitted now that missteps were taken in tallying the death toll there. And the death toll has now been rectified and it has increased by 50%. USA had been accusing China of hiding information and details. There has been Chinese secrecy. Even in December 2019, when the outbreak took place and doctors in Wuhan raised this concern online, the authorities in Wuhan actually tried to cover up the outbreak and even punish the doctors who were raising an outcry. But then it had to come out in the open. The total deaths in the city are now at 3,869. Nationwide death toll in China has also, because of this increased by nearly 39%. The total death toll in all over China is 4,632 and 3,869 in Wuhan itself. So China contained the disease in Wuhan, that is evident. Also, number of COVID-19 cases in Wuhan are 50,333. An official toll in the country, China has 1.4 billion population. And in this, the toll as such is quite low compared to other smaller nations like Italy and Spain. Spain's total deaths have been 19,500, while China, a huge nation, has said death toll is 4,632, while the disease outbreak took place in China itself. Spain's death toll is third highest in the world after USA and Italy. Then next is minor forest produce in exemption list. So, in the latest set of lockdown relaxations, Ministry of Home Affairs has now added collection, harvest, and process of minor forest produce to the list of activities that will be permitted. So, some relaxations are being given from 20th April. So, this will also be included. Minor forest produce include non-timber items. And bamboo has also been added lastly. Bamboo is actually scientifically a grass. So, it has also been added as a non-timber item as minor forest produce. By a recent recent modification to the definition a few years back. So bamboo, roots, seeds, fruits, flowers and plants, they are all minor forest produce. So their collection, harvesting and processing would also be allowed, and it is scheduled tribes majorly and other forest dwelling communities which are dependent on these items for their livelihood. So police has been preventing forest dwellers from leaving their home to collect minor forest produce because of restrictions, lockdown due to COVID-19, but now relaxation would be provided to them. Also, tea, coffee, rubber plantations have been given exemptions from lockdown. Even bamboo, cocoa, areca nut and spices plantations have been added up in the southern states to the list which will be exempted from lockdown. Then next is Bolsonaro fires health minister, calls for reopening of Brazil economy. So Brazilian President Jair Bolsonaro fired his health minister after clashing with him over the fight over how to fight the new coronavirus, and has again called for states in Brazil to end stay-at-home orders and said this was hurting the economy. So the Brazilian president has been known to call this COVID-19 as a minor flu, and he doesn't want the economy to be affected. He says the government cannot afford emergency aid to the poor for much longer. So he wants the economy to open up, not having a lockdown. So such is a differing stand being taken by Brazilian president, right-wing president Jair Bolsonaro. He had also been accused earlier of relaxations which resulted in huge forest fires in Amazon, which are called lungs of the world, the evergreen forests in Amazon in Brazil. And he actually has this stand of allowing clearing the land so that economic activity can take place. They cannot allow such a huge tract of land for forestation. So such are his stands. Then next is RBI to pump in rupees 1 lakh crore. So RBI has announced a slew of liquidity measures to ease financial stress and increase credit flow. So what it has announced is that liquidity infusion of 1 lakh crore, of which 50,000 crore will be exclusively for non-banking finance companies via banks. So out of this, 50,000 crore is for NBFCs through banks, and another 50,000 crore is for refinancing agencies like NABARD, SIDBI and National Housing Bank. So the problem for NBFCs was that banks were not offering them moratorium for repayment, while NBFCs, non-banking finance companies, were extending moratorium to their customers. So now this liquidity infusion is being provided by RBI through banks. So this here you can see the detail has been provided below. We'll look at it first. So you can see, so it will be this targeted long-term repo approach operation which will be initiated by RBI. So the banks have to invest the funds which will be provided to them in various investment graded bonds, commercial papers and NBFCs, non-convertible debentures of non-banking finance companies. So RBI stipulated that small and mid-sized NBFCs and microfinance institutions should at least receive 50% of these funds. So 50,000 crore can be availed through this targeted long-term repo operations, means banks can take money from RBI. So through this repo operation, they can loan money. And first auction will be of 25,000 crore on 23rd April. And they have to 50% of it provide to NBFCs. So in that also segregation is given, like 10% has to be invested in securities of microfinance institutions, 15% to be in securities issued by NBFCs, 25% in securities issued by NBFCs with larger assets. So smaller assets and larger assets. So this is the segregation being given, how the amount which will be provided to banks has to go to NBFCs through banks. And this investment has to be made within 1 month of availing liquidity from RBI. So this is what is the relaxation announced by RBI for NBFCs. And this investment made by banks in NBFCs and other entities would be classified as held to maturity. So even in excess of 25% of the total investment permitted. So if even it is in excess, it will be included in held to maturity portfolio. So that's there. Remaining 50,000 crore, which is going to NABARD, SIDBI and NHB, National Housing Board. That also the detail is provided here. You can see how much would go to each one of them. 25,000 crore to NABARD. Here you can see 15,000 crore to SIDBI and 10,000 crore to National Housing Board. So National Housing Board like supports housing finance companies, so they would also be benefited through it. So this is what RBI has announced for NBFCs and NABARD and SIDBI and National Housing Board. Apart from this, another announcement which has been made by RBI is that, as you can see separately, RBI has also increased ways and means advances limits of states by 60%. So we had seen ways and means advances. You can see the advances are given by RBI to state government since 1937. So the maximum amount of ways and means advances by RBI and the interest charged are regulated by various agreements between RBI and the state governments. So advances are given. It's basically advances given by RBI to the states. So how much would be given? Limit to that has been extended now because states also need funding. Also, central bank has reduced reverse repo rate. Repo rate has remained unchanged, but reverse repo rate has been reduced by 25 basis points. That is meant from 3.75% has come down to 3.5%. Because repo rate is the rate at which RBI, you can see it's given here, RBI borrows money from banks. So banks borrow money from RBI. Means RBI liquidity is moving from RBI to the banks. So this money is taken by banks. So repo rate is the interest rate that banks have to pay to RBI. And reverse repo rate is the interest rate which RBI pays to banks. So when banks have excess liquidity right now because so much of capital infusion is taking place, so what banks do is they'll keep the money with RBI and they will get interest. So that interest should not be high. That's why RBI has reduced this interest rate while repo rate has remained unchanged. So this is there. So here you can see how repo rate had earlier also been reduced significantly by 0.75%. This was on March 27, 2020. Repo rate at 4.4% and reverse repo rate as 4%. And then 3.75, now it has come down 25 basis points. 3.5%. So that's that. So various benefits were announced by RBI earlier too, and now these benefits have further been extended. So this also we discussed about NBFCs. So this is a gist of what we just discussed. This is another image giving clearer picture of how, you know, repo rate, reverse repo rate has been cut. How special refinance facilities have been provided. And lastly, here you have India says IMF liquidity boost may be costly. So Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has said country could not support general allocation of SDR by IMF because it might not be effective in easing COVID-19 driven financial pressures. And she says such major liquidity injection means IMF is ready to provide funding through SDRs. But then this will produce potentially costly side effects is what the Finance Minister is stating. And even US Treasury Secretary has raised such concerns. And if, you know, countries use these funds for extraneous purposes, then they will suffer costly side effects. So what is being proposed is actually that new SDR allocation should be done, is what IMF is ready for, special drawing rights allocation. So this would provide all 189 members of IMF with new foreign exchange reserve with no conditions. But countries are not ready. You can see US, India are not ready. So what are these SDRs also we'll see. IMF, you should know, it was created in 1946 along with World Bank, IBRD, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. That is another name for World Bank. So both were initiated around the same time. They're known as Bretton Woods twins. And main purpose of IMF is to support an orderly international currency exchange. So and it helps nations having balance of payment problems through short-term loans. Such. This is how they're called, Bretton Woods twins. Bretton Woods is actually the name of a village in New Hampshire in USA, where the delegates had met in 1944, and the initiation took place of formation of these two institutions, World Bank and IMF. So to support world economic and financial order. So basic difference between the two is also given here, you can see. So IMF oversees international monetary system, while World Bank's major objective is to promote economic development of world's poorer countries. It assists developing countries through long-term financing of development projects and programs. And here, the IMF's main role is to promote exchange stability and orderly exchange relations among its members. Foreign exchange financial resources of IMF are principally from quota subscriptions of its member countries, and World Bank financial resources are from borrowing on the international bond market. So IMF has the special drawing rights, SDRs, which were created by it in 1969 to be intended to be an asset held in foreign exchange reserves. So India's foreign exchange also has SDR as a component, like we have gold, cash, SDR. So that's how it is. So these were issued to supplement a shortfall of preferential foreign exchange reserve assets, namely gold and the US dollar. So they were allocated to participating members in proportion to the fund quota which they had. So every country has SDR quota. And SDR value is based on the weighted currency basket of four major currencies, US dollar, euro, British pound, and Japanese yen. And it is denoted as XDR. So it's also called paper gold. So it's an unconditional reserve asset to influence the level of world reserve in order to solve the problems of international liquidity. So SDRs are supplementary foreign exchange reserves. They're defined and maintained by IMF. It's not a currency per se, but it can be used to raise funds. And that's what IMF is proposing right now. It says we are able to lend about $1 trillion to its member countries. So, first line of defense, it says quotas. In normal times, IMF uses its quota-based resources for financial lending. Then second line of defense is multiple borrowing arrangements. So if there is a shortfall with that, then it can activate a new arrangement to borrow to. And third line of defense says bilateral borrowing agreements can also be there. So with individual countries. So IMF has come forward and says it can help countries address economic effects of coronavirus. It says there is this rapid credit facility and rapid financing instrument which can provide quick one-off financing to respond to health disasters. So you can see IMF can provide debt relief grants for the poorest and most vulnerable countries to help address public health disasters. When new financing arrangements can be done is what IMF says. But the developing countries as such, which cannot afford, the poor countries are going to benefit through this. Majorly, that's what is the idea. You can see if you look at SDR allocations country-wise, Cyprus, its foreign reserve, 90% of it is SDR. US has 73% as SDR. So that is there. So that is it. Thank you.